नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज जियोडेसिक टेंजेंट। जियोडेसिक टेंजेंट एट एनी पॉइंट ऑन द कर्व सी इज द जियोडेसिक विच टच द कर्व एट दैट पॉइंट। सो दैट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ जियोडेसिक टेंजेंट। द इम्पॉर्टेंट रिजल्ट्स, द टॉर्शन ऑफ asymptotic line and geodesic tangent are equal. Number two, torsion of asymptotic lines at any point that is equal to capital N cap dash, R vector dash and scalar triple product of these three vectors. Similarly, torsion of geodesic at that point is n scalar triple product of n cap dash and r vector dash. Both curve touches at point p. n cap dash r dash are the same at that point. So next is very important result expected for examination. Show that the torsion of geodesic tangent at any point of the curve on a surface is given by tau, which is equal to kappa b minus kappa a sine of psi cos of psi, where psi is the angle between geodesic tangent and principal direction, and kappa a and kappa b are principal curvature. So we know that the normal curvature and maximum and minimum values of that curvature is called a principal curvature, that already done in the previous chapter. Now we know that torsion tau, which is a scalar triple product of capital N cap dash and R vector dash, that is written in equation number 1. Now let principal direction are parametric curves. If principal directions are parametric curves, then it implies capital F is equal to 0 and capital M is equal to 0. Also, we know that tau is equal to scalar triple product of n cap dash r dash, and it is equal to 1 by capital H v first row of determinant v dash square minus u dash v dash and u dash square, similarly second row efg and third row lmn. Now simplify this determinant. So simplify this determinant, we get the value of 1 by h into this values. Now in the given question, capital F is equal to 0 and capital M is equal to 0. So first term, second term, first and second, these term is equal to 0, and similarly F equal to 0 and M equal to 0. So this term is equal to 0. Only remaining term is En minus GL into U dash into V dash. So 1 by H En minus GL U dash into V dash. H square is equal to Eg minus F square. Since F is 0, so H is equal to square root of Eg. Now substitute the value of H in this equation. So we get square root of Eg, bracket shuru capital N by capital G minus capital L by E, U dash into V dash. U dash is a DU by DS and V dash is a DV by DS. Now this is a geodesic tangent and the angle between, this is a V equal to constant. It means the direction is DV equal to 0. If V equal to constant, then DV, which is equal to 0, that is a tangential direction. So angle between these two lines which is equal to psi. So in that case, cos of psi is equal to square root of e u dash, and sine of psi which is equal to square root of g into v dash. From this equation, we can find the value of u dash and v dash. This is the value of u dash and v dash. Now substitute these values in this equation. When we substitute this value in this equation, so tau is equal to bracket shuru n by g minus l by e sine psi into cos psi. N by g, which is equal to kappa b. And similarly, L by E, which is equal to kappa A. Now we substitute the value of N by G and L by E, which is kappa B minus kappa A. So we get the required result, which is equal to kappa B minus kappa A into sine psi into cos psi. So this is our question, and this is very important question. Now next is, if two geodesic at right angles have their torsion equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So the given is, let tau 1 and tau 2 be the torsion of two geodesics which are at right angle. So this is a torsion of one geodesic and this is a torsion of second geodesic, and they are right angle to each other. If one geodesic makes an angle psi with the line of curvature, then other will make 90 plus psi. So other will make 90 plus psi. So tau 1 by previous question, by using the formula, which is equal to kappa b and kappa a sine psi cos psi, because psi is the angle between them. Now in the second case, the angle change from psi to 90 plus psi. So tau t, which is equal to kappa b minus kappa a, here psi is converted into 90 plus psi, and here psi is again converted into 90 plus psi. So we get this is minus sine psi minus time kappa b minus kappa a sine psi cos psi. So compare tau 1 and tau 2, we get tau 2 is equal to minus tau 1. So this is our result. Third is, again third question, of all geodesic through a given point, those which bisect the angle between the line of curvature have greatest torsion, right? Now, since tau is equal to kappa b minus kappa a sine psi and cos psi, multiply and divide by 2. So basically, we want to find the maximum value. So this is equal to 1 by 2 kappa b minus kappa a sine of 2 psi. The numerical value of tau is maximum when this value is equal to 1. So this value, if magnitude value, then this value is should be plus minus 1. So sine 2 psi, when sine 2 psi is equal to plus minus 1, then 2 psi has two values, pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. From this we can find the value of psi, which is equal to pi by 4 or 3 pi by 4. So this is our result. Now curvature of geodesic. Now in this article, we want to find out the curvature of a geodesic curve. Let R be the position vector at point on curve on geodesic. So R dash, which is a T, which is unit normal vector, again differentiate with respect to S. So R double dash, which is equal to T dash, which is by Freenet formula kappa into n vectors. So since the curve is geodesic, in that case, by normal property, n vector which is equal to capital N cap vector. So R double dash can be written as kappa N cap. Now taking dot product on both sides. Now this will converted into kappa. This is curvature. and r double dash dot n cap, this is equal to kappa n. This is oblique curvature, this is a normal curvature. So kappa n is a normal curvature at point P in the direction of geodesics. So by Euler's theorems, we know that kappa is equal to kappa A cos square psi plus kappa B sin square psi. So remember this result. Again, it is very important result. So kappa is equal to kappa A cos square psi plus kappa B sin square psi. So this is a Euler's theorem. Now, geodesic curvature from this. So this is for any curvature, the curvature vector at any point is r double dash, which is t dash, which is kappa n. Now vector r double dash at point P, remember this thing, can be expressed as a linear combination of the non-coplanar vectors n cap, r1 cap, r2 cap. These are tangential vector r1 and r2. This is a normal, unit normal to the surface. So this r double dash can be written as kappa and n cap plus lambda r1 plus mu r2. So this is a normal curvature and this is a tangential curvature. So which is kappa g, which is lambda r1 plus mu r2. A curve on surface is geodesic if kappa g is equal to zero. So this is a next theorem. Suppose let r vector be the curve on a surface. If it is a curve of a surface, then r double dash, as in previous result, kappa and n cap plus lambda r1 plus mu r2, these values. Now this values basically t dash, derivative of t. Now by Freenet formula, this can be represented as kappa n. So kappa n is equal to this values. Now this value is equal to kappa g. If the curve is geodesic, then remember that normal property, small n vector and capital N vector, these are equal. If these vectors are equal, then this can be written as kappa n cap plus kappa g. So it implies this values, they are kappa g equal to zero. So this is a first part. They cancel to each other. Now, if kappa g equal to zero, then the value of kappa g, lambda r1 plus mu r2 equal to zero. So it implies these are tangential vector. It implies these scalars equal to zero. So lambda zero and mu zero. If lambda mu zero, the equation will become kappa n is equal to kappa n n cap. It means these vectors are parallel. If these vectors are parallel, by geodesic normal property, the curve is geodesic. For any curve on a surface, the geodesic curvature vector lambda mu be intrinsic. So again, that formula that we already know, that this r double dash, which is equal to this, written in equation number one. So first, taking dot product with vector r1, if we take dot product with vector r1, so it will become r double dash dot r1. This value is equal to capital U, remember that, capital U, and this value is equal to kappa n n cap plus r1. They are perpendicular, cos 90 degree. So this will equal to zero because this is a tangential part. This is a tangential vector and this is a normal vector. They are perpendicular, so their dot product is zero. So remaining term is lambda into this and mu into this. R1 dot R2, which is capital E, R2 dot R2, which is capital F. So which is equation number 2, capital U is equal to lambda E plus mu F, which is equation number 2. Similarly, taking dot product of equation 1 with R2 vector, similarly, then we get this equation, R2 vector dot R2, which is equal to kappa N, this values plus this value. Now, this value is equal to capital V. Here this term is wrong. So, correct this term. This is a capital V, not a capital N. So, this is a capital V. If we write this term, so basically it is a capital V, not capital N. So capital V, this is a capital V. Now, if this term is capital V, now from this term is capital V, from this lambda F plus mu G, which is equation number 3, now solving equation number 2 and equation number 3, we get the value of lambda and mu. So this equation is in term of u, v, g, f, e, g minus f square. So in that case, lambda is equal to g u minus f v over h square, and mu is equal to e v minus f u, capital F u by h square. So this is our values. Now, after that, lambda and mu are in terms of E, F, G, and U and V. It means lambda, mu are depend upon these quantities, these fundamentals. So then they are all intrinsic. So it implies kappa G, which is lambda R1 plus mu R2, is intrinsic. So this is very important result. After that, the geodesic curvature vector of any curve is orthogonal to that curve, right? Now, again, by using the given formula R double dash, which is equal to this. So this is a T dash. T dash can be written as kappa N. So again, here, taking dot product with T. So when we take dot product with T, this term will be zero because they are perpendicular. Again, this term is zero. Again, this is a perpendicular. So we get this values dot T equal to zero. This term is equal to kappa G. It means kappa dot product T vector equal to zero. It implies kappa G vector is perpendicular to curve. Kappa G vector is perpendicular to curve. So, which is our result? We want to show that the geodesic curvature vector mean kappa G of any curve is orthogonal to that curve. So, tangent of this curve and geodesic curvature vector, they are perpendicular. It means kappa G dot T vector is equal to zero. So dot product is equal to zero. Now geodesic curvature for a curve, if kappa G lambda R1 plus mu R2, geodesic curvature vector, this vector is called a geodesic curvature vector, and its magnitude is denoted by this. And vector kappa G has direction making with angle 90 or minus 90. Now, this is important article, formulate for geodesic curvature. We know that kappa G lies in tangent plane and hence perpendicular to any. Why it lies between tangent plane? Because it is a linear combination of R1 vector and R2 vector. So it lies in tangent plane. It means it is perpendicular to n cap. Kappa G perpendicular to tangent to the curve. This is now also it is perpendicular to the tangent to the curve. This means kappa g perpendicular to t and kappa g perpendicular to n cap. Then it means kappa g parallel to the cross product of these two vectors. These vectors are t vector cross n cap vector. T vector is r vector dash cross n cap. So it means kappa g is parallel to n cap cross r dash vectors. Now, if this is a parallel, then this vector can be written as scalar multiplication of this vector. So kappa g, which is equal to its magnitude, into n cap cross r vector dash. Again, r vector double dash, which is equal to kappa and n cap plus kappa g, this values. Now substitute the value of kappa g in this equation. So we get equation number one. Now taking a dot product of n cap cross r vector dash. This is dot product because we want to remove this term, this vector. So this vector will be removed if we take the dot product with this vector, then this and dot this is equal to 1. So when we take dot product, this values will become this. Now in this scalar product, two vectors are same. So this value is equal to 0. This is 1 and this is n cap cross r dash dot product r double dash. This values, so from this, what is this? This is a kappa g geodesic curvature, and the value is scalar triple product of n cap r dash r double dash. So this is a value of geodesic curvature. If we want to find out the value of geodesic curvature, then we want to find out the value of scalar triple product of n cap r dash and r double dash. So this can be written as t vector, and this can be written as t dash vector. So kappa g can be also written as scalar triple product of n cap t vector and t dash vectors. Clear g? Now next topic is geodesic curvature in term of parametric t in place of s. So that we will discuss in next lecture. So thank you very much.